Hello everybody and welcome back on my channel. Today's video is gonna be a review on two new releases from Zoologist. And Victor Wong has released these amazing fragrances. One of them is called Hyrax and the second one is called Moth. And first of all, let's have a look at the packaging because these are my two first Zoologist perfumes. I have never owned any of them in a full bottle. So as I saw this presentation, I fell in love because I always loved the way how Victor kind of like picks animals and all these beautiful designs. And when you open this beautiful box, this is how your bottle looks. Oh my God, I absolutely love it. And I also love that here you have the name of the animal, Hyrax, the name of the perfumer, this one was created by Sven Pritzkleid, and then you have the inspiration, the description of the scent, as well as the notes that it features. So, since I have Hyrax in my hands, we are gonna talk about it first, and then we're gonna move on to Moth. So Hyrax was created by Sven Pritzkleid, and you know that Sven is my friend. I have created a fragrance with him, and as I learned about this collaboration between Victor Wong and Sven Pritzkleid, I was a little bit afraid because those guys are crazy and their imagination and fantasy has no limits, which is great, but I was like, whoa, what they are gonna create? Oh my God. And I know that Sven can go really extreme with animalics. So as I learned that it's gonna be Hyrax, I was like, oh my God, okay, I'm really excited. So I expected this fragrance to be really intense and a little bit kind of like overpowering and very challenging to wear. And I was really surprised that it is actually not like that. This is actually really, really wearable, much more wearable to me than Bat, that I cannot wear at all, and Hyrax is actually very pleasant. It is an animalic beast, so I think to really appreciate its beauty, you need to be a fan of animalic fragrances. If you're not, then I don't think that you will love it, but I think it will be a nice experience to try it because I have never tried an animalic perfume like it, even from Sven's collection. So it is truly particular and it was inspired by Hyrax. This is a wild African animal, and this Hyraxium element that he produces, when it becomes a stone, it can be used in the perfumery. So I want to tell you that Hyrax is a really well-blended scent, and when you first spray it, I want to refresh it. When you first spray it, it smells very rich, and there is a hint of spiciness, and there is a beautiful rosy scent. It is a Turkish rose, which is very opulent, which is very rich and round, but the note of Hyraxium is noticeable already in the opening, so that animalic wildness is there from the beginning, and it shows up even more. So this fragrance develops as a very animalic, sexy and heady scent. Actually, it makes me feel high. And I feel high when I eat spicy food. I don't drink alcohol and I have never smoked anything, so I don't know how that really feels. But it makes me feel high and heady. I don't know, I just feel that my head is like, whoa. And I think that is because of that alcohol whiskey touch that it has. And this fragrance is very opulent, you know, it is very sexy and it is even a little provocative. This is not an easy fragrance that you want to wear when you're going to work. This is the fragrance that you want to wear when you want to seduce or you want to feel cozy, because the base of this fragrance is created out of resinous notes. It has the note of patchouli, it has musks, amber, so it is really warm and nicely blended. And even though this fragrance is quite intense, guys, and it is kind of like beast mode, It is not hard to wear at all, and I think you can wear it throughout the year, like in the summer and in the winter, of course, when it is really cold, it feels more cozy when you wear it. And in the summer, you don't want to overspray it because literally one spritz is enough, guys, because it is really, really intense. It is extra de parfum. So the longevity and performance couldn't be better. And another thing that I wanted to tell you, it is unisex in my opinion, and it is kind of that perfume that both men and women can wear, and it might smell on them a little bit differently. Just depends on the skin condition and also environment condition, because I can imagine that in the more kind of like tropical climate, maybe the florals will come through a little bit intense. And when it is like really dry, it would be even more animalic. I don't know, that is just what I think about it. And the last thing that I want to tell you about Hyrex is that I can see that people who really like to be on the countryside and miss that vibe of the countryside air that is full with aroma will really love Hyrex, because it feels like being in the nature. It is like wild, and it feels like playing with domestic animals and just breathe the air full of a little bit earthy aroma, a little bit woodsy aroma, a little bit of floral aroma, just everything mixed together. So if you like that vibe, you definitely need to try out Hyrex, and just try it anyway because it is really, really cool, and I promise you, you have never smelled anything like it. Alright, let's move on to the second new release that is called Moth, and I really like how it looks. The idea is the same, it looks the same, I believe all bottles look the same. And this perfume was created by Tomo Inaba. I'm sorry for mispronouncing the name, but it was the same perfumer that created Nightingale, if I'm not wrong. And first of all, I love the color of this fragrance, like the juice is so dark and it matches the scent so well, because I imagine moth coming from darkness and just flying to the ray of light and kind of like gets burned. I don't know, it's just like moth that goes into the fire and you know, and becomes ash. I don't know, maybe that's strange, but guys, this perfume might be the most interesting one that Victor Wong has in his collection. And I know it is crazy to say that, because all his fragrances are so unique and so interesting, and they all smell so differently, but Moth, I was blown away as I first tried it, and I really love how it develops, because it goes through several different stages. It is not a boring scent. It is very, very interesting to experience it. So I just want to refresh it, because I have the dry down, which is magnificent. And when you actually first spray it, it has kind of like a gothic vibe. It is very spicy, and I've told you that I'm not the biggest fan of spicy fragrances, but this is very different from those oriental spices. This is kind of like more floral spiciness, and it is really, really dark first, so it is kind of like smoky and woodsy and spicy. But I know that it develops as a floral composition, and I absolutely love those floral elements. I feel like this fragrance completely transforms, and you definitely need to take your time with it, and you definitely need to experience it on your skin. I can totally imagine that it will smell differently on everybody, like slightly differently, not dramatically differently. And in the dry down, it actually gets a little bit sweetish because of honey. And I feel like this is the perfect fragrance to wear in the night. It is, for me, it is nighttime scent only. I think that when you wear it throughout the day, it is more floral. So now it's afternoon and it's more floral on me. But as I wear it in the night, it is just so sensual and so seductive. Guys, it's so cool. And it is another beast mode scent. It lasts on the clothes for 3 or 4 days. I got really strong sillage and projection when I first sprayed, but even after a few days, it really stays on the clothes. So be aware of that. This perfume is another beast that you don't want to overspray. And what I wanted to tell you about this fragrance as well is it has even a powdery side. And it is not like a super irisy perfume or violet fragrance. I think that it features the note of heliotrope and it makes it like a powdery veil around this fragrance. Like it gives that powdery undertone to it because it is much more on the smoky and opulent side. And I want to tell you that it will make you hungry because it is delicious as well. So now I smell it and it's so cool. And by the way, Hyrax and Moss, they're perfect combo. They smell so good together and oh my god, I just love it. And both of them are so unisex. That is another really cool thing. So I think that Moth is more a nighttime scent. And Hyrax, you can actually pull it off even throughout the day. And Moth is a very grown-up scent. It is mature. You know, it is not fragrance that young people, I mean like young, what is young, it depends, but like in the 20s, who don't know, who could not really appreciate something really complex. Because this fragrance has different layers, you know. So this is more a mature scent. I think that people who are more advanced, who have experienced different fragrances, they will really enjoy Moth. When Hyrax can be worn even by very young people because it's just really fun. Everyone will ask you what are you wearing when you are wearing Hyrax. So both of them are really cool and I think that Victor really develops. I mean, like all his fragrances are really cool. Every new release is so different from the rest and that is really very inspiring. And you know how much I love Victor Wong and all his fragrances, and I actually want to tell you guys all who are watching this video to support him because his work is so impressive. Like all his effort that he puts into the packaging, into the description of the fragrances, he thinks through each and single detail and he gives so much freedom to the perfumer to represent the animal the best way they can. And I think that that work really needs to be appreciated. And that's why I highly recommend you to get some samples. He has samples, trial sprays and full boils. And he has something for everybody. You will love at least one scent from his collection. And I mean, for the quality that Victor brings us, he's prices are amazing because he plays a fair game with us and I really appreciate that. And that's why I highly recommend you guys to try out these new releases and also get yourself a sample pack if you have never experienced any of Zoologist fragrances, because that is an awesome experience. This is like to open the whole other world of uniqueness. And that was all from me today. Please check out my reviews on other Zoologist perfumes. The links are down below. And if you enjoyed watching this video, then please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel because that helps me out a lot. And feel free to share this video with your friends who might be interested in Zoologist perfumes. And the link where you can purchase Zoologist perfumes is also in my description box. So make sure to check it out. And that was all. Stay tuned and we'll see each other in the next one really soon. Bye.